From the Mission of Hope, we're gearing up for their busiest time of the year, and it all starts on Sunday, November 10th, with Picnic for the Hope, their annual celebration and fundraiser.
Yes, we have Emmett Thompson here with us, and Ginger is here with us as well. First of all, good to see you.
Good to see y'all. Thank you.
Absolutely. We're getting close to that time of year when you start talking about Christmas and rural Appalachia, but as we say many times, you do it 52 weeks a year. Mm-hmm. And you have a neat banquet coming up that's a little bit different than years past.
It is, y'all. You know, we have built a wonderful tradition for Mission of Hopers, both our long-term friends and new friends, the first Thursday of every November for years at Rothschild's, who are wonderful friends to Mission of Hope. That's our friend-raiser fundraiser, our annual banquet. And our banquet team came to me recently, and we decided to try something totally fresh, new. So we're having a good old timey after church and Sunday school. Seriously, having a luncheon for the Hope. It's going to be a picnic kind of format. It's going to be at Rothschild's. It's going to be checkerboard tablecloths.
Fried chicken and fixings.
Yes, just for you. But it's also an opportunity for not only our seasoned Mission of Hope friends that we couldn't exist without, but we have always wanted to invite young families with children. Hard to do that on a weeknight, and we're really excited about doing it.
Yes, we're hoping that people will gather together after church, come as a group, and enjoy the lunch and all the things that are going on.
Well, and Ginger, this helps Mission of Hope in so many ways. We were just talking about the need. You see it, firsthand. Tell us a little of how this will help.
Well, this will help a lot going towards our Christmas activities that we have. We have a lot of deliveries. We have 28 schools that we deliver to, along with Appalachian Ministry Centers. So we provide the food and the clothing and the hygiene bags and toys for the kids. So there's lots of needs there.
And the needs continue to grow, right?
They continue to grow.
I mean, you have the coal situation going on up there, and a lot of folks out of work, and
it just trickles down. It is, and you use the word, Beth, a domino effect can put somebody that's in a poor state of affairs and just real life happens and throws them further behind. There's a rhyme and reason why we go where we go, and always have. From when, God bless him, Bill's First Stories helped birth this almost 25 years ago, it's the rural depressed areas of Appalachia, and working through the schools and these sweet mom and pop ministries. And we want to make this a fun event. We're going to have a Southern Gospel group and a Bluegrass group.
There's only
one speaker, and if he gets too long, they're going to pull him off the stage.
Perfect then.
How about that?
And I love to bring kids too, bring families. I love that.
Bring your friends, bring neighbors.
Yeah.
A great chance to introduce Mission of Hope, hopefully see some new friends, and really help tackle this need that's just continuing to grow.
Absolutely.
It's the picnic in November. It's November 10th, 12:30, Rothschild Conference Center, and there's information if you'd like to attend.
All right, and missionofhope.org if you'd like to learn more about this or anything that they do. Great website. They're also on social media. Going to be a fun event. Always good seeing you.
You too.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you for what you do. We appreciate it.
All right, and we're back after this.